On National Signing Day, Travis Hunter, the nation's number one recruit who was committed to Florida State, shocked a lot of people when he unzipped his jacket to reveal he'd be flipping to Jackson State. The promise of having more people and coaches to identify with at an HBCU is a major draw. So I decided to look deeper into how diverse the Big Ten is in its head coaching ranks when it comes to women's and black-dominated sports.
One hand, I feel honored that I get this opportunity to kind of step into a really coveted role. And on the other hand, it's disappointing that there aren't more women of color who have either gotten the opportunities or who are you know, in these roles for a long sustained period of time.
In 2021, the Big Ten filled all three of its open head coaching positions in basketball with people of color. Wisconsin women's basketball head coach Marisa Moseley was one of those hires, and she recognizes the value of her players having a black female head coach to look up to.
You can't be what you can't access, right? And so even if you can see it, it's almost worse if you can see it, you can't access it. So I think for you know, young women of color to see me in this position, to not only know it's possible, but that I can also tell them how you can go about doing that.
It's no secret basketball is a diverse sport at the playing level. Out of 28 head coaches in Big Ten basketball, 12 are women, 2 of whom are black, and 4 are black men. In comparison to the other Power 5 conferences, the ACC has the Big Ten beat with 5 black male head basketball coaches, and the Big Ten falls in 3rd place with black female head basketball coaches behind the SEC's 5 and the ACC's 4. However, the Big Ten's 12 female head basketball coaches is the most in the Power 5.
Now, basketball isn't the only black-dominated sport with a disparity in its head coaching numbers. Capital One Field here is home to Mike Locksley, one of 3 black head coaches in Big Ten football.
I think what it means to me is that the Big Ten obviously is at the forefront, if not at least one of the conferences that it's important to them to have diversity.
When asked if he thinks the lack of diversity in head coaching plays a role in black student athletes choosing an HBCU over a Power 5 school, Big Ten Commissioner Kevin Warren said he thinks the diversity is strong.
I mean, we all can do better, and we're focused on doing better, which we will. I think at the end of the day, you know, our student athletes want to make sure that they play for coaches who can just help them to get better.
While Coach Locksley can't speak for his players, he knows he brings something different to the table when he's recruiting young black men to join his program.
I do know when I sit on people's couch and some of the players with, as we found the coalition that I started, you know, 65% of the football players at the FBS level are minority football players, and that the representation of coaches is only around 13%, that there is a unique perspective that I bring when I go into a home, because a lot of these homes are a lot like the home I grew up in.
Coach Locksley and Coach Moseley say young athletes need role models and big dreams.
You know, on the day I got into coaching, I dreamed that I would one day lead Maryland, and it's never going to be easy, and that you just got to continue to dream big and work toward achieving those dreams. And when you do have a chance to reach them, pay it forward by reaching back and giving back.
You can truly be anything that you set your mind to. If you don't see it, then go and make yourself that first so that other young women can see that it's possible.
And one important question to ask, who is making these hires? And is there diversity in those positions? The Big Ten has 3 black and 5 female presidents and chancellors, and 5 black athletic directors. That's all the most of any Power 5 conference.